In this video, we will show you how to set up voltaic cells for experiment 12. The first step is to clean the half cell block. Obtain the half cell block from the hood and take it out of the bag. Use a dropper to remove all the storage solution from the wells, including the central well. We don't want to pour the solution directly into the waste bottle because this is often a very messy process. So take the time to use your dropper to remove the solution from each well. Once you have removed the solution from the outer wells, you will also want to remove the solution from the central well, which is your salt bridge. Once you have removed all of the storage solution, you will want to grab your wash bottle and head over to the sink. You will rinse your electrochemical cell at least twice with distilled water and pour the solution down the drain. Once the wells have been washed with DI water, you can dab the well plate with a paper towel. In this part, we'll show you how to prepare your copper and zinc voltaic cell. Obtain KNO3 solution and pour this into the central well. This will be our salt bridge. You want to make sure that this well is filled almost to the top so that it provides a good connection for the other wells. After you have obtained KNO3, you will want to get the zinc solution for your half cell. It should have a 0.1 molar concentration. Use the dropper to put the solution into one of the wells. Make sure that the liquid level in this well reaches up so that you make a connection with the salt bridge. Once you have added your zinc, you can close this bottle and put it away, and then obtain your 0.1 molar copper solution. You can put this copper solution in any well other than the one that contains the zinc. Again, use the dropper to fill the well full enough so that the liquid level is high enough and can make a connection to the salt bridge, as shown here. Again, cap the solution and put it back. Now you will need your metal pieces. The zinc is the flat, long piece, and the copper is the copper-colored piece. Make sure that your zinc piece doesn't have any corrosion on it. You can use your steel wool to brush it lightly before performing the experiment. Using the voltmeter you obtained from the stockroom, connect a lead to a piece of metal. Make a tight connection between the alligator clips and the metal pieces. Turn on the voltmeter to read voltage, that is the V on the voltmeter. Then immerse the metal pieces in their corresponding solutions, copper in the copper solution and zinc in the zinc solution. You should read a voltage of about 0.93 or 0.95 volts. Make sure that you keep your electrodes steady so that you get an accurate reading. Sometimes students reverse their leads and get negative voltages. Make sure that you check your voltage before recording it so that you get an accurate reading. Here we show what happens when the leads are reversed. If you see a negative voltage reading, as is shown here, you may simply reverse your leads and remeasure your voltage. In part C, we are doing the same thing as part B, except now Silver is our cathode and copper is our anode. You will record cell potentials at different concentrations of copper and silver. When you finish recording all of these voltages, you can empty the solutions in the waste bottle and refill the wells with KNO3 solution. Then return the half cell setup to the bag in the hood.